Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Planet Zoo and our Elderwood National Redwood Park build thingamajiggy. Today we're going to build a huge natural habitat for the Przewalski horse. I'm going to go with Przewalski. It could be Przewalski, I'm not sure. Maybe I want to go Przewalski. Anyways, I did Google it. People said it's a shuh sound, so we're going to roll with that. So we're going to build a big old habitat for our horses. It's going to be much more wild feeling than the last habitat we did, the one for the Amur Leopard, which, in retrospect, I regret a little bit because I quite enjoyed making the more zoo-ish habitats, and we're definitely leaning back in that direction in our next build, in our next habitats. But it made sense for the horses, just because, you know, horses feel like they should be wild and they should be roaming free and kind of doing their thing. You know, I didn't really want to it just felt wrong in a way to contain them so much. And I found this beautiful image of this artist's rendition of this kind of redwood creek with this waterfall and all these fallen trees, and it was this beautiful thing. I thought, all right, we'll see what we can do, and we'll stick a restaurant in there and stuff like that. So setting up the boundary there, as you can see, it's quite a large area, which is why this video took a while to come out, basically, because you can see we're building out this whole area, and the problem is because we're kind of surrounded by rock and we're surrounded by cliff, that cliff has to be rock, right? It can't just be, like, you know, terrain, because terrain doesn't look very good in this game. I mean, the terrain looks fine in this game, but it doesn't make for effective cliff walls. You have to use the rocks, and that means pain. Basically, I am begging for, like, larger rocks for this game. It would make my life 1,000 times easier if I could plant down some, like just an actual rock face wall. I don't know how useful that would be for everyone else, so I'm not expecting it to ever be a thing, but I can imagine it would be, right? Like a huge slab of, like, cracked, craggy, pockmarked rock, like a square or rectangular slab that's, like, four times the height of the other rock things, and you kind of just plant it against a wall and it makes it look like a cliff. That'd be really nice. I think that'd be useful for a lot of people. It's quite hard to... It takes a long time to do stuff like that at the moment, because you have to use each rock individually, as you will see throughout this video, because this entire area is going to be surrounded in rock, which is one of my only problems with the build, really, just in that it feels a little bit disconnected from everything else in a way. It doesn't feel like it's part of the park, it's just a little bit in the wild, but it does have that vibe that's gone for with Le Horso, which is how they say it in Canada, I believe. So that's our pathway in there. In terms of, I'm doing like a little restaurant, I wanted a restaurant that looked out into the creek. I wanted a very natural feeling restaurant, one that was, you know, made out of wood and had the same sort of materials we've been using. And in my head I had a kind of very open plan dining area with, again, lots of wood and fires and kind of like, you know, camping, but in a restaurant, if that makes sense. I realize here, I'm building my little fence and just nothing, you know, special, but interestingly enough. And I realized I was missing a teeny tiny little piece of that mesh. I didn't realize now I built the entire bloody fence, and then I realized one part of the mesh is missing. So it's missing on every single one of those. This is why you double check these things. The mesh is very hard to see if it's selected sometimes, so you never know. But yeah, so you're just gonna walk around this kind of like little rocky outcrop and look down into the creek, which will stagger up into the distance, and the horses will gallop and have fun, because we're in the middle of a redwood forest. But on the other hand, I feel like horses, they need like a wide open area, right? It just feels wrong to me somehow to sort of contain the horses too much, but I also wanted it to retain that Redwood Forest National Park kind of vibe. So it's kind of an open area, kind of like an opening in the forest, but there's still quite a lot of forest there, blah, 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 blah. It's just like a little canyon. This bit, I didn't show you this in the last video, and I'm not really showing you there, but this bit I'm really happy with, because the whole reason we're doing this section, honestly, is because the path curves down here from the monorail that you saw in the last video, and it curves around to the right, beyond the waterfall and on the other side of the river that you can see from the monorail, and the way that the path kind of sneaks around on itself just looks really cool. We're not going to build this section up now for a while. We're going back to the Siamangs next, and we're going to do a much more zoo-ish build. You know, I'd like to build an actual monkey house kind of thing, and do, because this was a lot of natural work. This was tons of rock work, tons of terrain work, very little building work. But I really enjoyed doing that with her, and this me fixing the fence. But I really enjoyed doing that with the leopard, so I'd like to go back and do more of that. In terms of story and stuff, you know, I've seen there's a fence at the start that's been kind of broken in. You know, the idea is very much that this is an area that people lived in, and that an area that existed before the zoo was here. So it kind of accommodates for that, but it's never meant to be spooky, okay? No spookiness allowed. So the fence is kind of broken, but it's in a theming sort of way. Does that make sense? And it's theming, but it's light theming. It's not crazy theming. Alexa, stop. What is she on about? I don't know if you could hear that. I hope so. God knows what she just said. I heard Nat Walsh. I don't know who Nat Walsh is. I don't know who Nat Walsh is. But so much rock work. This is kind of what turned me off. This was fun, and I think the final result is totally worth it. I really like how this build came out. It's got this beautiful open air, wild kind of look to it. But my God, the amount of rocks I had to place to make this work, because there's a cliff surrounding the entire area. You know, it's like a little gullet, like a little canyon kind of thing. And you can't just leave the natural Planet Zoo terrain, because natural Planet Zoo terrain does not make for good cliffs. It just doesn't look good. You need to use the rocks. And the rocks are freaking tiny. So it's absolutely painful. It really is. I would kill for a... Literally kill. I will kill this delivery notice I have. That's right. I'll go that far. In order to get like a big sheetrock kind of effect, something that makes it so much easier to build large rocky areas, because right now you have to stack them and it looks unnatural and it takes a billion years. There's a few things Planet Zoo could do to make large exhibit building a lot easier, like a foliage brush, priority number one. I don't know if that will ever be possible in the confines of the game, but it would be absolutely incredible. My God. Oh, that would make my life better. Please play some more Prehistoric Kingdom now that I'm thinking about it. Is planned for this week. I've got something in mind. So working on the restaurant. So I say it's meant to be... I kind of wanted some modern materials in there. So there's a bit of glass in there. Just because the Arctic wood itself is very dark and it needs lightening up a little bit and needs modernizing a little bit. Just remember that I got rid of the glass, however, so never mind. Just kind of leaning in that conservation theme, so we're using the new conservation items. We're going to rim that with a little bit of wood, shut up, and then we'll ladle some grass work over the top of that as well. Just meant to be very, it's kind of modern in shape, but the, you know, natural materials, naturally hewn materials, and I just like the idea of this kind of casual restaurant looking out over onto the horse habitat, basically. And still keeping this in touch with nature kind of vibe. This Yorkshire foggrass, I think I used about 2,000 pieces of it in this habitat, honestly, like this whole area is, because I'm not using it as a individual thing, it's more like it replaces the natural grass, right? It kind of has that kind of look to it a little bit, in that it just looks like a more interesting grass, and then so that kind of supplements the existing long grass, which doesn't look super exciting on its own, and then I add the flowers and stuff over the top of that. So basically, all the grass in this zoo will be Yorkshire grass, and then other things get added over the top. You've got to think of it as the new base grass rather than the actual base grass. It's how I'm thinking about it. It just looks so nice. It's so pretty. Makes me so happy. Just trying to think of detailing to add here. Just adding more wood slats, really. Just trying to make it a bit more interesting. Look at time for more Yorkshire grass, of course. It's always time for more Yorkshire grass. It's so good. The habitat as well. Every inch of the habitat will be Yorkshire grass. It is my obsession. I absolutely... honestly, this zoo would not have worked, I don't think, without these new grass items. They have... They changed my life. They changed the building life entirely. It's the first time we've really had the ability to have interesting grass in the entire game, essentially. In the past, you had to, like, sink bushes and trees down into the ground, which could look okay, but it's very hard to get... you know, lots of detail in there, and it's very hard to make it look natural. But now, it's beautiful. Makes me so happy. Anyways. So yeah, very open, you know, the trees, the tables were all outside. Well, some of the tables were outside, some of them overlooking. There's a tree in the middle, there's some candles on there. It's kind of just romantic, wild, camping, chill, very expensive restaurant is the vibe. I was going to add some fairy lights and stuff like that, but I found it a little bit overpowering. You'll see me attempt that later on. That was actually a big revelation for me. Oh, I'll add, you know, fairy lights and I'll add them to the exhibit and it'll look really nice, but it was just a little bit too much, unfortunately. You're always going to have ideas that you then just need to, I don't know, try out. You know, you never know until you try it out in game and see what it looks like. Not all ideas need to be committed to. But on the inverse of that, very, very often I will work on a habitat and it looks terrible until about 5 minutes from the end. And that's the point it all eventually comes together. So you've got to see things through, but don't get too attached to your ideas at the same time. Which sounds like very counterintuitive advice. Anyways. So yeah, as you can see, I kind of worked on the entire area other than the habitat for the vast majority of my time here, because the habitat is humongous and I knew in my heart that it was going to take absolutely bloody ages, and I wasn't excited about it. It's just the rock work I wasn't excited about, like covering the surrounding cliffs in rock. I knew was going to be a pain in the ass. Please, Frontier, a big rock, a big cliffy rock. I'm crying out for it. The community needs you. Anywho, sorry, my shoulder's killing me. Shoulder, stop it. I'm sorry. That's what my shoulder sound like. Actually, no, I'm working out, so my shoulder's like, I'm sorry. I don't know what she's with, yes. I don't know. I've got to say, I'm still really happy with this build. People were very, very nice on my leopard build. I'm very thankful for that. I do think this is, by many magnitudes, my best work. Yeah, I don't think it's even particularly close, actually, it must be said. I think it's pretty miles ahead at the moment. I mean, Amsterdam had some nice bits as well. Amsterdam kind of lost itself when it became a zoo, but when it was a town, I liked some of the stuff I did. Yeah, here, I'm trying the lights, but the problem with the lights was that it kept taking away from the impact of the candles to an extent, so I got rid of those. And then about now, my game's going to crash. Any second now. Yep, there we go. So my game crashed, not really sure why. It crashed a couple times in Amsterdam as well, and usually when I was messing around with lighting, so I suspect that is part of it. It's just the game struggling with the lights. But I logged back on and thought, okay, can't keep going like this. We do actually have to work on the actual bloody habitat. So, oh, this was my first mistake, by the way, adding the trees before I did the rock work, because now I have to kind of like finagle my way behind the trees to do the rock work, and it's kind of a pain in the ass. If anyone has any references or anything for the Sea of Mine habitat, feel free to let me know those in the comment section down below. I do have a huge bunch of references, but there isn't really a big theme or big idea tying it all together quite yet. I was going to do a waterfall like this, but this just doesn't. Again, the waterfalls are too small. You know, I'd love a larger waterfall item just like this. It's hard to build big habitats, but I guess this is not what the game is designed for at the end of the day, right? It's not made for habitats like this, because habitats like this don't really exist in zoos, so it's fair enough, really. I'm being very selfish. But because you can't really build big waterfalls that look super effective, I thought, okay, we'll do like a staggered waterfall kind of thing. And this looked awful for so long. It looked so bad. It came together at the end. I still don't know if I'd want to look at it up close, but God, it was a disaster for a long, long time. What was I saying? Builder. Oh, yeah, so, I mean, I've not been writing the story. I've been writing, fun fact, by the way, I'm working on a horror novel right now. About 6,000 words done in the past week or so. What's it on about? Yeah, so, as I say, there's no secret horror story for this park, right? There's no secret cult or anything like that. I'm trying to stay away from that kind of thing. But I did want a story. I did want something, a tale integrated into the park that the visitor could experience, because it's not just a zoo, it's the town that was always here and the national park that was always here. And I like that infusion of the real world with my zoos. That's kind of just how I like to build, generally speaking. Never really planned for that to be a thing, but as it turns out, that's what I like to do. So we're going to lean in that direction once again. However, I think my way of doing that is mainly going to be notes and little items that you find as you walk around the zoo. The problem is it's not a circular zoo. It's not a route or anything like that. It's wibbly wobbly. But I guess the idea is that you have to piece it. I don't know. So if I was going to do like a series of notes, let's say, you know, you find a few notes behind a cabin hidden somewhere, and it's like journal entries, maybe, kind of thing, you know, So you start off with day one and you're reading all this person's story, and that story kind of develops as you walk around the zoo. The problem is you might run into day one and then day 37 and day 15, depending on which order you do the zoo. So I don't know how I would accommodate for that, really, unless there is a... We get to the end, we do a map, and we do like a preferred route. You could ignore the route, but if you follow the route, you'd get the story correctly. Does that make sense? As I said last video, the idea is very much for this to be a little bit like Firewatch, in that it's meant to feel a little spooky. Or Gone Home, as one of you mentioned in the comments as well. That's a good shout. Gone Home, for me, I thought it was a horror game for like the first hour. It turned out to be, you know, a piece on, again, grief and... feeling lost and uncomfortability with your sexuality and all this kind of jazz. Not, you know, that was a bad thing, that's the whole point. But, right, that was it and Gone Home, yeah, as far as I vaguely remember. Anyways, and Firewatch did the same thing. It felt like a horror, and yeah, people died, sort of, but it was, again, more a rumination on grief and loss and all this kind of jazz. And that's very much what I want to do. I know that's a nice optimistic thing for a zoo to be about, but this was a national park, and this is a town. This is an old mining town that has long been not abandoned, but the mining rush is over, the gold rush is over, and America is filled with old mining towns that used to be absolutely chock-a-block. So they built the infrastructure for these big towns, and then when the mining boom ended and the mines ran dry, these towns were all abandoned and left to rot, essentially. And, you know, there's maybe 800 people left behind at the end. So that's kind of the theme, I suppose, and that's the idea. Funnily enough, the book I'm writing, which is disconnected from this, but I am pulling ideas from it, literally has that as the justification for the town. It was an old mining town that was then abandoned. What am I on about? Yeah, there's not much to say here because I'm just doing rocks. I got like the basic foundation of the habitat done. I thought, right, can't keep putting this off. I need to do 1,000 rocks and make like a cliff face. It's just, it's a very difficult thing to do, honestly. There's about 4 or 5 rocks. Number one, number two. I learned to love number two a lot. Number one, number two, number four are very, very useful for building rock walls. My rock walls tend to look quite staggered. You can see they're going up in steps. You can do it more haphazard and more sharp and more sort of jagged rocks, but I find that takes longer and it's hot. It doesn't look as good if you're going to do like a wide swathe of cliff, you know. It's, at the end of the day, you need to look after your mental health and your brain. You know, you can't just do everything. I mean, some people can, but I can't. Especially if I want to keep uploading these bloody videos. Very excited about the Sea Mangs. I'm still excited about the park. It's taking a lot of work. I've already put more into this than I have in most other parks I've done, but I really enjoy it, honestly. But I'm excited to get back to the actual building work, because there's just so many rocks. I wish they'd put, I'd put them in a group so I could know just how many there are. But it's nearly done, though, I think. There's a few more in the actual habitat itself, a little bit of terrain. I'm trying really hard to get better at having those open spaces and to think about how the rocks would fall and, you know, not just have these big grassy areas. I don't know, I've got a different approach when it comes to foliage now, and I think it's working a lot nicer, generally speaking. The grass is helping, however, it must be said. The grass is helping immensely, but you get a nice feeling there for what the habitat's going to look like. It's not going to look much different than what you're seeing right there. Just obviously with the rock work finished and a little bit more foliage, because we're actually pretty near the end, as it happens. Yeah. I was going to do something else in the habitat, maybe like a hut, like a ranger station kind of thing, but with the restaurant already there, I thought that might ruin that open air feeling, that wild feeling I'm kind of going for. I would like to do another building. I've already done the Firewatch Tower, as you saw in the last video. Someone told me to do the Firewatch Tower. I'm like, well, I'll show you the Firewatch Tower. Pay attention, YouTube. grass. Yeah, basically, I just went everywhere that I'd already placed the grass and put more grass. It just looks better than the grass. So just put it bloody everywhere, essentially. It's not as good on any bendy bits, because it's quite a large iron, but I don't know, what else would you have? I've got the Firewatch Tower, but what other kind of buildings would you have in the middle of this area? I want to do like a mine. We're going to do like a little fishing town harbour kind of thing. Actually, this is very similar to my book in some ways. But other than that, I don't really know what buildings you would find in this area. Or what, like, it's not meant to be part of a habitat. It's kind of like an ambient building, if that makes sense. It's there to provide backdrop and there to provide intrigue in the skylines, in the sightlines. Shut up, it makes sense. But yeah, tons of grass. Lots of grass. Lots and lots and lots of grass. And that's about it. Just kind of like pulling back all the time to where you're mainly going to view the habitat from, where you're first going to see the habitat from. Just kind of thinking, okay, how do we break up this area? How do we break up this area? I think it's quite handy to have like a few specific sight lines that you like to use, and then look at them and just think, okay, if I was designing this just to look pretty, you know, what would I do? How would I break up this area? Is there enough balance in the trees? Is it open enough? And you see, I've tried to do that where it's very open in the middle, and kind of like gets a little bit more dense with trees the further out you get. So there's a lot of room for the horses, but hopefully it still feels like you're in the midst of that big forest. It's always the hope. Whether that actually bloody works is a whole other kettle of fish. Using the same plant life, generally speaking, as I was in the surrounding area. I've tried to basically... So everything's grass, as in the eel grass? No, the York grass. But the flowers atop them change depending on where you are. And the general foliage choices change. There's more Scots pine stuff in this area. And there's more... whatever these plants are, and the twin flowers are only in this area, really, as far as I know. Stuff like that. Just gives each area like a little bit of its own personality while still using 99% the same stuff. Not going to use the Virginia creeper, but I really want to use the Virginia creeper. If not here, then somewhere, because it just gives this really nice pop of colour that I really, really enjoy. I think I'm going to try to integrate it into the sea manx. But apparently that is it, and we are done. That's the lovely title of my video, Planet Zoo Timelapse AdVO, always in capitals, so I don't forget. We're going to hop in game and check out horses and check out the habitat. I'll see you in a sec. Right then, folks, here we go. Just to show you what I meant when I was talking about the tower earlier, that's the tower I was referring to. So that's really not like the focus, but as you walk past, you get to see it. So let's go ahead and hop into our... How do I even do this again? Explore mode. Pop up here. So we kind of did this in the last video. I will work on that, I promise. I've done all the other signs, but not the animal info signs. It's been a very busy week. Anyways, so you head up the hill. I've done some more work in this... Let's get up this bloody hill. I did some more work in this area, as you can see, hopefully. I kind of did some more work on the building and did like an outcrop and sort of plant life on top of that. It all looks quite nice now. I like this area a lot. This is obviously... The idea is eventually all these sight lines will eventually be fully developed. We're not going to be working on this area for a while now. We're heading back down there for our sea mangs, and we want to do this sort of area because that's the area you see when you first walk out. But eventually we'll end up back here, and that's where the path comes out I was referring to before. So you can see the waterfall there, and then the path from the horse kind of goes like this and comes out down there and walks along there, and there'll be a bridge there connecting with there. You see how it all ties together? It's like Dark Souls, very much the idea. So anyways, we have our creek picture. What I do is I take Firewatch posters and find a relevant one, and then I add like a little PNG of a horse, basically. I'm not sure what I'm going to do when I run out of Firewatch posters to use, but we'll figure that out when we cross it, come to it, whatever. Let's head down. So this is all new since last time. Some of this I did off camera. I'm doing the sort of the joining bits off camera because otherwise I'll go insane. For some reason, just working without recording, I find a lot easier. You know, I can tab out for a while. I can go change my music for ages if I want to, all that kind of jazz. I don't need to think as much, basically. So it's nice to do some bits off camera. That will say, hopefully, I don't know what I'm going to do here. I'm just going to grab like a no entry sign or something like that, or like a keep out warning kind of thing. It's meant to have a little bit of that horror vibe, but only an inch, only a little tiny bit. And you're meant to see, you know, there's fences over there, and obviously it's been broken down to sort of let you in. I just feel like this is the kind of thing you get a lot. And it, again, it was inspired by Alan Wake, if I'm totally honest. So the fence is caved in, and you walk forward, and there we go. Przewalski Creek. So I've done a little bit of work. There you go. I think that's kind of beautiful. If I'm honest, I'm pretty chuffed with it. Yeah, I've done a little bit of work since last time. Not too much. The main thing I did was just check if the horses could escape, basically, and they could all around here, and they could all the way around there as well. But that's all been fixed, hopefully, at this point in time. There's, I think, 5 horses in there, 1 male, 4 females, because I do like to keep it to, you know, the kind of numbers and the sex differential that they would have used in reality. But yeah, it definitely has the vibe I was going for. Oh, what is... Oh, hello. Not sure how I did that. Yeah, it definitely has the feeling. You can see what I mean by the size being, it's huge. So all this is surrounded by rocks, and then there's trees all the way around the top. But it does feel like a little, it's like a little creek that runs through the forest and kind of splits the area open. And it just gives the horses more area to roam around in, which is very much, I wanted them to be happy at the end of the day. I can't quite come up with how I'm going to design their info signs, but I'll get there. Moving along. This is the only bit I'm unsure of. It kind of like looks down on you like an evil god, which is cool, I guess. I don't know about that, if I'm honest. Adorable. So there's my sign, so the stuff. So yeah, this area, again, this is not going to be worked on now until we come back here later on. I'm just trying to work on the individual bits so I don't get sort of overwhelmed. But if we nip down here, eventually the path will come down here. Do, 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 do. And as you can see, that is across from the monorail kind of thing. So it's all going to link together really nicely, is the hope. Back up the hill we go. Running up that hill, as the lovely bush would say. It sounds like a bizarre children's book more than the reference I was making it. The lovely bush goes to Washington. Right, anyways, moving along. So this is our restaurant. Again, wanted more trees in this area. Wanted you to feel like you're dining within the forest itself, at least to some extent. Need to come over. I don't know about this. This is meant to be like a restaurant sign, but I'm not sure I'm even going to keep that, so that's why I've not done that yet. Yeah, so quite shadowed, this area. I really like, you always, when you look up, you kind of get the mist effect and this, you know, the softness coming through the tree line. The game, I don't think, handles light. What I'd really like is this to be lighter like it is, and this area here to be a little bit darker. I don't think the game handles that super well. It would make this look a lot more dramatic, and as it happens now, when you've got an area like this with no light, this works because I think because of the contrast here, but only when you're here. When you just look at that, it looks a little bit flat and boring, where in reality it would have much darker shadows going on. You know, this would all be shadowed, blah, 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 blah. But yeah, just meant to be a very nice sort of casual, outdoorsy eating area. Sort of a, these signs are stupid, by the way. Why can't I do this on multiple lines? It makes no sense to me. I think I can probably put a TV screen in there or something like that. Yeah, nothing special about the restaurant, really. Just wood. staff area. I wouldn't say this is done either, really. I just had to get fixed. I'll do a little work on this. I'm probably going to do it tonight, actually, before we move on to the Sea Manx. But yeah, that whole area. I mean, look at that. Look at the lighting. The game is beautiful sometimes. But yeah, that's that whole area. If we hop out of this mode for a second, go down here, so we've got like a little outdoor seating area that, as I say, looks out into the habitat itself, like so. And let's check out the habitat. So it does go all the way to the back. I did do the work all the way to the back. The cliffs go all the way over here. And oh, I'm going to put another tree there, actually, now that I look at it. You're never going to come up here, so the fact that that's like that doesn't matter. But what does matter is that it has to look like hello, where have I gone? Where am I? I'm on a magical mystery tour. It has to look like the forest continues off into the distance, you know what I mean? This is not the edge of the forest. It's not really, it's not meant to feel like a habitat per se, this area. So, you know, they're here because they can't actually escape out of these cliffs, but this just happens to be a little bit of the forest where it's kind of tumbled in, and it's a bit more cliffy, but the trees do carry on into the distance, is always the idea. And I don't think there's anything special about it. I just think it's come together nicely. That might be a little bit too much, but I do think it looks nicer. You know, when you look back and it's got the trees in front of it, it kind of like calms it down a little bit. Big log, there's two logs stuck together. It's not perfect, but what are you gonna do? Horse, hello horse. What's your name, horse? Xanadu. Oh, it's an amazing name. Xanadu. Maybe not as Waterloo. yeah, they can walk. Oh, hello, rock. What are you doing? No. There we go. They can walk around the whole thing. They can cross the river over here. They couldn't cross the river last you guys saw this, so I've had to change that up as well a little bit. But, yeah, I don't know. Pretty happy with it. I don't really have anything else to add. They're just gonna chill, live their horsey lives, I suppose. I'm really happy, yeah. I don't really have any problems other than the ones I've mentioned. Yeah. Well, spend more time with the horses. If I was a horse, where'd I be? I would be going into the thing. The thing is cool, yeah. Having the time of its life. I don't think it's actually playing. It's just kind of just walking through it and things are happening. Just give you a little tour around what's going on. It'd be nice if I could have less shadow in certain areas, but you have to kind of... It's hard with the redwoods, because the redwoods inevitably make a lot of shadow, so you kind of have to... You're not just thinking about where you want the trees to be, but you're thinking about where the trees will create the right shadows. Because if, you know, if this whole area here was shadowed and you didn't have the horses in the light, it just wouldn't look as good. The plant life, as you can see, I think it looks really nice. This long grass, we've got this London fog grass and the flowers and the twin flowers looks really nice. But as soon as you get into the shadow and that lighting goes, it looks less interesting, especially when it's like huge swathes of it. You see, this is not very visually interesting over here. So you need the light to break that up, otherwise it just doesn't work. Also, there's a tent, just because... Shut up. It's a habitat, but it's not a habitat. You know what I mean? I see that problem there. Let me just fix that. Yeah, so I don't really have anything else to add. Who have we got here? Who have we got? We've got Mug Setseg has returned again. Lovely. We've got Uran Chimeg. We've got Uyun Chimeg. Erhi. Who's injured? We'll sort that out in Xanadu. I don't think I've got a vet in the area, so I'll see what I can do about that. But, it looks really good! Yeah, I'm chuffed. Absolutely chuffed. So, that is our horse habitat. You see there's a waterfall here. It kind of like leads into this cove here. Then you walk down there. But as I say, this area is going to be neglected for a little while now. So eventually that'll all be built up with rock, and that'll lead on to more habitats over here. But, next video, we're going to head down here instead, because I kind of, as I say... I want to start building up, so this whole left area is done, sure, but as you walk through this whole right area, it's obviously stupid. So, it's time to work on this bit. This is probably just going to be forest with a trail going through. Eventually, that's going to be like a little fishing village, harbour kind of thing is the hope. Maybe a habitat there. But we're going to build the sea mine habitat probably in this area here. Because I want something in front of that cliff face, because that is going to be agony. This cliff face is not going to be easy to make look good. I'm going to put some wooden slats or something against the stone and try to build up the whole thing a little bit more. But this makes me nervous, to say the least. Although I've done a good job making it there, so maybe I just do that all the way down. Maybe it'll be okay. I think the wall is too thin, though. That's why I'm going to do some like struts or something. Either way... I like the idea as well of having this path. But what I might do is drop this area here to this level. And then I like the idea of the path here leading into the top level of the monkey house kind of thing. So you'd then look down on them, and then if you wanted, you could drop down over there, or you could drop down here and then walk around the habitat. I don't really have any great ideas for the sea mines yet. I've just got some sort of rough reference images, but we shall end it there. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you lovely folks very, very soon. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video. All that jazz. All that jazz. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.